suicide bed. The short story from memory. In one of my earliest stunts, I slashed my little sister's fingertips with a razor blade. Afterward, I took the razor to my own hand to show her how insignificant the wounds were and to make her stop crying. That's just a creepy little kid story. The chemical hell started with Valium when I was 9. Multiple prescriptions, plus granny's sleeping pills. By the time they canceled my prescription, 6 years later, I was hardcore addicted. I suffered through a long summer of withdrawal. I later tried to commit suicide with a second all overdose. I swallowed 100. It was a temper tantrum against my options, the choices I saw for my life. I vomited for days. Did this failure to die mean the next time I'd be the type to take everyone down with me? I shot dope for 7 years. Junkie life is a suspended state of being. Through some of it, I hated myself. But mostly, I was indifferent. It was numbness, interspersed with a drive to stay well. In my best drama queen fashion, I continued to try to kill myself. Poisoning, intentional overdoses, wrist slashing. I was never able to stop the picture from going on. I was fucked up in my own private hell. It irked me that I was a big, baby-faced white boy. I wanted to be dark, androgynous, beautiful. Instead, I was sweet, like apple pie. I wanted to slash my face, despite my all-American, wholesome good looks. I tattooed fuck you with a spider, cross, teardrops, and a crown of thorns on my forehead. I couldn't shake the martyr complex. It got so bleak and a lot less easy. If I could just sleep and never wake up. If someone could just put me out of my fucking misery. Am I just a manifestation of my fucking self-destruction? Is this just more suicide?